Welcome back. As we promised, our second main topic is going to be totally economic, and to shed light on important incidents which took place recently, we are very much delighted to have with us via phone former Assistant Foreign Minister Ambassador Gamal Bayoumi. A very good morning to you, sir.
Good morning. How are you?
I'm fine, thank you. And you're always an added value to our programs, and we'd like to ask you or to speak, to shed more light with you on the latest economic developments. Whether we agree or no that Egypt tenure already ended as the EU president, but the fruitful efforts and activities which took place during this year are really gaining more admiration by the whole continent and maybe by the whole world. Recently, President Abdel Fattah el-Sisi received the Secretary General of the African Continental Free Trade Zone, who really expressed his appreciation to the efforts exerted by the head of state during his tenure as EU president, and speaking about the Egyptian efforts to accelerate or to promote the economic arena in general in the Black Continent. If you want to elaborate on that, sir.
It seems that we have a very appreciated experience, well accepted all over Africa. Mm-hmm. And we performed a good story of success in the last few years when Egypt joined the common market of East and South Africa, the COMESA. Our trade with this part of the African continent was tripled in the last few years. Mm-hmm. So we want to generate and generalize this experience all over the continent, because we have two other subcontinent groups. Mm-hmm. We have the west of Africa, and we have the Middle Africa group. What we succeed, and we did it successfully, is to create a larger free trade area in Africa,
yeah,
which will combine all the African countries, more than 50 countries mm-hmm. all over the continent, with a population of 1,200 million inhabitants, which yep. is the largest regional group. It's huge, of course. And another good news that more than 35 countries recognized and ratified the agreement for that. So the agreement is in action now.
Yeah.
Now I want to tell all the Egyptian producers mm-hmm. and exporters that they can export all over Africa mm-hmm. without any custom duties or any trade barriers.
Great.
I hope that this will expand more our trade, our exports, and this, of course, means creating more investment in the continent and in Egypt.
Because the political leadership was not satisfied.
New generation.
Sir.
Pardon?
Yeah, I'm sorry for the interruption, because the political leadership, or President Abdel Fattah el-Sisi, in many occasions said that he was not at all satisfied with the volume of trade exchange between Egypt and African countries. How do you see the coming period? In your opinion, is it going to witness more and more expansion or more and more increase in the volume trade exchange between
Absolutely,
Egypt and...
Absolutely, because we were lucky to have again the summit and the presidential level of our foreign relations, especially with Africa.
Yeah.
We are well presented in Africa on the ambassadorial and ministerial level, mm-hmm. but we were lacking the presidential presence for more than 20 years.
Mm-hmm.
And this is not good for the African taste.
Mm-hmm.
They like to see a president, they like to be well received in Cairo. Once I was conveying the invitation to a president in Africa, and he said, "C'est mon rêve." Mm-hmm. This is my dream to go to Cairo.
C'est mon rêve.
So
we
have to come back to this. We did it, and we are lucky that our president really is very active.
Yeah,
he is going everywhere, all over the world. I am really trying to run after him, seeing what he's doing in Tokyo, then in Paris, then again in Tokyo in the same week,
yep.
to defend the African cases, well presenting Africa, because now we are not satisfied with trade only.
Yep.
We want to expand this to investment, and we are asking all the developed countries in order to come more and more to invest in Africa mm-hmm. with the Egyptian experience, because our experience is much older
yep.
and it's much well accepted and much cheaper.
Yep.
And China, Japan, and European Union accepted this Egyptian initiative, and I hope this will make our relations with Africa more and more enlarged, whether in
yes,
trade
sir.
Or investment, or the Egyptian presence as yep. experienced and our experts also.
And, sir, to echo what you're saying, it was not a surprise to see the African Bank for Development awarding President Abdel Fattah el-Sisi for establishing roads and infrastructure projects in the year 2020 in appreciation to the huge achievements carried out under his auspices in the transportation sector in general. How do you see this award, sir, and to what extent it's saying that Egypt became a role model for Africa, particularly in holding or in establishing mega projects in this sector and in infrastructure sector in general?
Very important to underline such an effort, because one of the challenges against the African aims for more development and investment is the transport.
Mm-hmm.
We are lacking good maritime transport, good airway traffic, and of course, the roads also.
Mm-hmm.
And our dream, it was to make a sort of a very large road between Alexandria and Johannesburg.
Mm-hmm.
We are going to do that, so the African continent will be connected also by the land transport.
Yeah.
And I want to tell you also that we were lucky to have organized our land transport within Egypt with the German and European experience. As you will see now that the numbers on our cars are new system. We got it from Europe with finance from Europe and with the German technical help. We shall expand this to all our brothers and neighbors in the African continent. And I hope that we shall connect
mm-hmm.
all the African countries, whether by maritime traffic or airway traffic or road traffic.
Yes, sir. And to add to what we were saying, we are also speaking about what took place yesterday with the directives of President Abdel Fattah el-Sisi to instill the industry of electric vehicles in Egypt, as Egypt is a promising market in this sector in specific. To add to all this, the City of Gold, which is going to be established under the auspices of President el-Sisi, as it's going to be provided with very elegant exhibitions and fairs, well-trained workers, to add to the already historic artifact in Egypt, which started years and years ago. How do you see these projects, sir?
We are expanding in every
direction.
Industry. We have a good aiming and future for it.
Mm-hmm.
We knocked the door last week for the car industry, especially the cars using the gas, the
mm-hmm.
cars using the solar energy. Now we are knocking the door of the gold industry. We have a huge history concerning gold mines. The mask of Tutankhamun is a well example for that. Oh, the treasures of the old Egyptian treasure is, of course, good part of it is made of gold. And now gold, of course, is a good sort of saving the wealth.
Yep.
Especially in the time where all the currencies are not in good health.
Yeah.
So we are doing this. We are really expanding everywhere, whether it is in industry, agriculture, in different industries. And gold come over and above all these efforts, which I think it's just one more step towards many, many other industries.
Yes, sir. And all these projects, whether mega projects or even the SMEs, are also taken into consideration well by the state. All these projects are made facing the challenge of COVID-19 repercussions, this global phenomenon which really hampered big economies all over the world. How do you see this balance which was made by the state?
Yes, we have to change our culture, because Egypt as an ancient country is really fell in love with pyramids. We like big, big things like pyramids, like mega projects. But countries can make good development depending on medium and small and tiny size industries.
Mm-hmm.
If you take the German model, and Germany became in 2009 the largest exporter of the world, 80% of what Germany is exporting, mm-hmm. it comes from small and medium-sized industries, and not at all of the very famous names you know, and I know. It's not Siemens or Mercedes or anything. No, it is small companies which we never heard about.
Yeah.
They made this miracle of making their country the largest exporter. So in Egypt, we need that. And of course, if you go to cities like Asyut, mm-hmm. with the carpets, if you go to Damietta with the furniture,
yep.
if I tell you that we have more than 50,000 small attics in Damietta to make furniture,
yep.
this is very small project. Mm-hmm. And we need to finance them. The central bank is doing a fine job to finance all these small projects.
And Arabic
this is the way
city,
we are building now,
yes.
For more development.
Yep. Amen to that. You know, sir, I always enjoy our discussions. I always learn. I always know more data and accurate information about what's going on, particularly on our economic arena. You're always an added value to our programs. Well, our economic expert and diplomatic figure, former Assistant Foreign Minister, Ambassador Gamal Bayoumi. Thank you very much for your input, sir, and have a very good day. Right after the short break, we are going to turn back with more. Stay tuned only on Nile TV International.